Hi everyone. Okay. How are you all of you? I hope you are all fine. Okay. Welcome to today's session. That is, we are going to learn about the general characters of the super class Agnatha. Okay. It is a belongs a which one? The vertebrate. Okay. So the super class Agnatha. Agnatha means, here see, this is the subphylum vertebrata. Okay, this is the super class Agnatha. This is the super class Agnatha. It belongs to the subphylum of vertebrata. Agnatha means, A means absent. A means absent. Gnatha means jaws. Gnatha means jaws. See here, lacks of the jaw. Lacks of jaw. Okay, jaws are absent. Those are called Agnatha. This is the super class of the invertebrate subclass, subphylum. See a jawless, primitive, fish-like aquatic vertebrates. Okay, their body forms are fish-like structure. See here, these are the examples of the Agnatha. So, see here, this is the body form. The body forms are fish-like and aquatic vertebrates. They live only in a water. That is why they are the aquatic vertebrates. Next, internal ear base, one or two semicircular canals in their internal ears. Okay, we have two types of ears. In all animals, the external ear, this is the external ear. The inner part of ear contains the internal ear. This internal ear contains the two semicircular canals. Okay. And the class. Next, going to class Cyclostomata. Under this super class, there is a class that is Cyclostomata. Here, in this word, okay, there are two meanings. See here. This is a cyclo. Cyclo means round. Cyclo means round. And stomata means mouth. Stomata means mouth. They bear the round mouth. Round mouth. That is why they comes under the class Cyclostomata. Okay. This mouth is a round in a structure. Okay. That is why that class is the Cyclostomata. And the body is scaleless and long, slender and eel-like. See here how many structures are present. Scaleless. Okay, generally, fishes have the scales, but the fish-like structure is present, but scales are absent. On their body, the scales are absent and the long, they are long, slender, the body is a cylindrical in shape and they are eel-like structure. Eel-like means their body forms are eels-like structure. Okay. The next, mouth is circular and suctorial. Circular means mouth is round and suctorial means they can fix on any other body form and they can suck the food material. That is why their mouth is the suctorial. Okay. Next, tongue bears the horny teeth. Okay. They doesn't have any normal teeth. The teeth is a horny teeth. Next, respiratory organs are 6 to 15 pairs of the gill slits are present. The gill slits are, okay, 6 to 15 pairs of gill slits are present as a respiratory organs. Okay, heart is two-chambered heart as in which animals two-chambered heart is present? In a fishes. You are right. Fishes have two-chambered heart. Like that, in this class, Cyclostomata also contains the two-chambered heart. Next, renal portal system is absent. It is belongs to the excretory system. In this, renal portal system is absent. Okay. These are the examples of the Cyclostomata. See here, this is the lamprey are, what are they called? Petromyzon. This is the Petromyzon, and this is a one of the example of the cyclostomata. And another example is the hagfish or myxin. Okay, see here, this is general characters of the Petromyzon and myxin. It shows the enodromous migration. Enodromous migration means they live in a marine water and they can migrate to the fresh water. After completion of the spawning, they are going to die. Okay, so this type of the migration is they can show, and they shows the ammocete larva. Ammocete larva means the development is indirect. The larval form is present, that is why the direct development is indirect. And the another one is in a myxin, the development is a direct. These are called as a scavengers. These hagfish are marine fish. Myxin is called as scavengers because they can live on dead bodies of the aquatic bodies. Okay, so these two are the examples of the cyclostomata. I hope you are all understand. Thank you.